लास्ट क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ ऑप्टिक्स एंड ऑप्टिकल रे ऑप्टिक्स एंड ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट. सो लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड रे ऑफ लाइट, बीम ऑफ लाइट, व्हाट इज मीन बाय कॉनकेव मिरर, कॉन्वेक्स मिरर एंड रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट एंड पोल, प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस एंड सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर, फोकल लेंथ. सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम बेसिक थिंग्स. So today and our last class also we are discussing about the relation between F and R, means the relation between focal length and radius of curvature of a concave mirror we are deriving in last class. So in this class we are deriving mirror equation or mirror formula. So in this class we are deriving mirror equation or mirror formula. So before going to start this derivation, so we have to know some few concept, means where the light rays are incidenting, where the light rays are reflecting. So first of all we are taking a concave mirror. So in last class I told concave mirror means it is a converging mirror. Concave mirror means it is a converging mirror, means when light rays are incident to concave mirror, all light rays are focused at a particular point and we will get an image. And next C is the center of curvature. For example, in first rule some node points are there. In first point, when the light ray is parallel to principal axis, so which is principal axis, this line is principal axis. So according to definition, the line which joins the center of curvature and the pole, in last class only I told the line that joins center of curvature and pole we call principal axis. So in first condition what happens, we are incidenting the light ray parallel to principal axis. We are incidenting the light ray parallel to principal axis. When the light ray is parallel to principal axis, so it is passes from the focus. So which focus? Principal focus. This is the first rule. So what is the first rule? When the light ray is parallel to principal axis. Light ray is parallel to principal axis. So which is principal axis? The line CP is the principal axis. The line is parallel to principal axis. After reflection from the mirror, it passes from the principal focus. First condition. When the light ray is parallel to principal axis, it passes from the principal focus. So second rule. So what second rule tells? So we are taking same a concave mirror. Same we will draw a pole. Next, center of curvature. So this time, suppose if the light ray is directly incident to the pole, so it will shows the laws of reflection. Which law? First law. So first law what it tells? The angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Means if the light ray is directly incidenting to the pole, so means it will shows the laws of reflection. So first one, if the light ray is parallel to principal axis, it passes from the principal focus F. So F means capital F. Next, if the light ray is directly incident to the pole, so means what happens? It will shows the laws of reflection. Means in which angle we are incidenting to the pole, in that angle only it will reflect. This is first case. This is second case. Third case, if the light ray is directly incidenting from the center of curvature, it will simply retrace its path. Means in which direction we are incidenting, in that direction only it will retrace its path. So first one, when the light ray is parallel to principal axis, it will passes from the principal focus. In second case, if the light ray is incident to direct to pole, it will shows the laws of reflection. In third case, if the light ray is passes from the center of curvature, it will retrace its path. Means in which angle we are incidenting, in same direction only it will retrace. Next, fourth condition. passes from the principal focus, if the light rays passes from the principal focus, it is the reflected light ray is parallel to principal axis. If the light ray is passes from the principal focus F, the reflected light ray is parallel to principal axis. So if we have to know these four node points, if you know these four node points, means we will simply directly understand the mirror equation and mirror formula. First one I will repeat once again. If the light ray is parallel to principal axis, it will passes from the principal focus, first point. Second point, if the light ray is directly incident to the pole, the reflected light ray is, it will shows the laws of reflection. Laws of reflection is the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. In third point, if the light ray is passes from the center of curvature, if the light ray is passes from the center of curvature, so it simply retraces its path. Next, fourth one, the light ray is passes from the principal focus. If the light ray is passes from the principal focus, the reflected light ray, the reflected light ray parallel to principal axis. Okay, come to derivation. I hope you understood all four node points. So next, mirror equation and mirror formula. So mirror equation, mirror formula means we are taking a mirror. So which type of mirror we are taking here? We are taking a concave mirror. So means we are taking a pole. P means the center point of a concave mirror. The center point of a mirror we call as pole. So we are taking a object. The object is denoted as AB. AB is our object. So AB object is placed in front of a concave mirror. So what we are doing? AB is our object. AB object is we are placing in front of a concave mirror. Means if the light ray, the first light ray is the striking to the point M. So after reflection, it passes from the principal focus F. Next, second case, the light ray is incident to the pole. According to second rule, according to first rule, this is the light ray is parallel to principal axis. It passes from the principal focus and it will meet at this point. And next, second one, if the light ray is incident to pole, the reflected light ray also meet in this point. Next, in third case, the light ray is incident to center of curvature, it will simply retrace its path. See the direction once again. The light ray is parallel to principal axis. The reflected light ray is passes from the principal focus F. Second case, the light ray is incident to directly pole. The reflected light ray shows the laws of reflection. Next, third case, the light ray is incident to passes from the center of curvature. The reflected light ray is simply retrace its path. Means all these lines are, light rays are meet at the same point. We will get an image. So where is the object? Image object. AB is our object. So here A dash B dash. A dash B dash is our image. AB is our object. A dash B dash is our image. So here we are writing in opposite. Means we will get an real and inverted image. In the mirror equation, mirror formula, concave mirror produces the real and inverted image. Inverted means opposite to original direction. The original direction of the object is, arrow mark is AB. When we see the image, its direction is changes. So we are writing image A dash B dash. So object is A B. In this case, first we have to consider the triangle. So consider the triangle A dash B dash F. Similar triangles A dash B dash F is equal to M P F for similar triangles. So in this case, MP is considered as straight line. MP is not a curve, MP is a straight line. So where is the point? We are considering the triangles. Where is the triangles? A dash B dash F, this triangle. I am taking separately A dash B dash F, this triangle. And next, another one triangle F P M or M P F. So this triangle we are taking. I will write separately A dash B dash F. This is the first triangle. Another one triangle M P F. So this is the what is the similar between these two triangles? We are taking two similar triangles. So what are those two similar triangles? First triangle A dash B dash F. A dash B dash F. So this is our triangle. Second triangle is F M P. So F M P or M P F. You write any one. So consider the similar triangles. A dash B dash F is similar to M P F. So what are the similar here? Similar points is A dash B dash by MP, because of A dash B dash is similar to MP. A dash B dash is similar to MP. Next, second one. A dash B dash is similar to MP and F B dash is similar to FP. So first case, A dash B dash. A dash B dash is similar to MP and F B dash is similar to FP. F B dash is similar to FP. So consider the equation 1. So see the equation once again. Consider the triangles. Where is the triangles? A dash B dash F is one triangle. So MP F is another triangle. So compare these two triangles. So what is the difference? A dash B dash is, A dash B dash is similar to MP and F B dash is similar to FP. So we are writing similar triangles. MP is similar to AB because of MP height or size. MP is similar to AB because MP and AB both are in same size. Okay, sir. So MP is, we are considering MP is similar to AB. So writing in the place of MP, we are writing AB. So in the place of MP is, MP line is similar to AB line. So we are writing in the place of MP, we are writing AB. Okay. Next. Consider triangles. Consider another two triangles. So we are considering the other two triangles. So compare between these two triangles once again. So compare with these two triangles once again. I will write separately. A, B, P. One side. Another one. A dash, B dash, P. So here, what are the similar terms? A dash B dash is similar to AB. So here A dash B dash is similar to AB or AB is similar to A dash B dash. Next, here A dash B dash is similar to AB and P B dash is similar to BP. See once again, A dash B dash is similar to AB and P B dash is similar to P. Consider the equation 3. Sorry. Consider this is equation 1. This is equation 2. So comparing equation 1 and 2. Comparing equation 1 and 2. So here A dash B dash AB meaning is F B dash F P. Here A dash B dash AB meaning is P B dash minus P B dash P B. So we are writing the equation F P dash by F P is equal to P B dash by P B. So F B dash by F P we are taking from equation 1. P B dash by P B we are taking from equation 2. So comparing equation 1 and 2. So you are writing equation 3. So F B dash. So F B dash how we can write? F B dash we are writing in different form. Means P B dash minus P F. P F or F P. So F P or P F both will give same meaning. See once again. So F B dash. So F B dash means P B dash minus P F. P B dash minus P F. So what is remaining? F B dash. So P B dash minus P F give the same meaning of F B dash. So we are writing in the place of F P or P F. You write down. You are permanently. Next. So from the which is object distance, which is image distance from the object to mirror or pole, we call object distance, we are denoted as u. Object distance means the object to mirror, we call object distance denoted by small u. From image to, so a dash b dash is our image, so a dash b dash image to pole, we call image distance denoted by v. Object distance from object to mirror, we call object distance u. From image to mirror, we call image distance v. From pole to principal focus, we call as focal length F. So here we are writing. So what is PB dash? PB dash means PB dash. PB dash is a image distance. PB dash is the image distance minus V. So why we are taking minus V? According to Cartesian condition, if the incident light ray, if we are all the distance are measured from pole, all the distance are measured from pole, if the light direction, if the distance are measured opposite to light direction taken as negative, light direction is moving in this direction, from the pole we are measuring distance in opposite direction. So we are taking PB dash is minus V. Next, PF. PF also minus F. From pole to principal focus, the length we call focal length. So PF also minus F means the same rule according to Cartesian convention. If the incident light ray object distance are measured opposite to light direction, we are taken as negative. All the distance are measured from pole only. PF. And next, A, next, PB dash is equal to minus V, PF is equal to minus F. Next, P to B, PB, PB is equal to minus V. So PB is equal to, PB is equal to minus V. So PB also minus V because of Cartesian sign convention. Next, so what is the PB dash meaning? PB dash meaning is minus V. I will write. So already minus PF. So PF is equal to minus F. So minus minus. So I will write plus F. Next, PF. PF meaning is minus F. Next, PB dash meaning is minus U. Next, PB meaning is, PB dash meaning is minus U, PB. Sorry. PB dash meaning is minus V. PB dash meaning is minus C, PB meaning is minus C, minus C. So according to this equation we are taking. Or, so we have to write down this equation in another form. All the negative terms get positive, all the positive term gets negative. V plus is minus, minus F, plus F, and V and U. So we have to write down this equation. UV, cross multiplication, UV minus UVF is equal to VF. UV, UVF and VF. Next, divide equation 3, consider equation 4. Equation 3 divide equation, throw out. Divide equation by UVF. We have to divide the complete equation by UVF. If we divide the complete equation by UVF, UV remaining is 1 by F minus. Divide the complete equation by UVF means U cancel, F cancel, what is remaining? V is remaining. Divide the complete equation by UVF, so VF, what is remaining? 1 by U. So what we will get? So finally we will get 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by U. Outside means the right side, 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. So this is our